Hello, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Hawk Talk. I am your host, Bryce Johnson. We're going to be doing things a little bit differently this week. Women's tennis is in the CCC tournament. Men's tennis is in the CCC tournament. Women's lacrosse is in the NCAA tournament. So instead of talking to just one person or a couple people from one team, we're going to be talking to all of them, baby. I'm so fired up. I'm so excited. This is going to be such a fun episode. So let's run it. So our first guest today is Devin Sarazin, senior captain and forward for the Roger Williams University women's lacrosse team. And Devin, what does it mean to you to make the NCAA tournament this year?
I mean, this is huge for us. We, my freshman year and sophomore year, lost in the CCC championship. And obviously last year we didn't have a chance to compete for that title. So this year, having the opportunity after everything, all this craziness this season, to go to the championship, come out with the title, and move forward to the tournament round, which no one on this team has experienced yet, is just honestly exhilarating. I'm so excited to see what's to come, and I'm very excited for everything that we've accomplished so far.
Absolutely, and we can't wait to see how you guys do in the tournament this year. And what is it like to have such a crazy season with all the COVID protocols and everything, and the journey of this spring kind of culminate in success by winning the CCC championship and moving on to the NCAA tournament?
I think after this season and coming out on top, I think it shows how resilient our team is. We've definitely gone through some highs and lows this season, and it's definitely made us stronger, as you can see coming out where we did. So proud of everyone able to move forward. And unlike past seasons, you know, we've always been a really close team, being able to gather all the time, having team dinners almost after every practice. I was definitely nervous coming in, not being able to do that as much. And we've come together stronger than ever and closer than ever. So I think that's a testament to the culture on our team, being able to persevere through all of that. And I'm just so excited for what we've done and where we're going.
That's awesome. And I'm wondering, you know, what was going through your mind as those final seconds ticked off the clock and you realized, wow, we're about to be Commonwealth Coast Conference champions?
I mean, it was crazy to come out winning, you know, not only winning, but winning by six, and watching that clock run down. So much like adrenaline. I was so excited. I mean, to be able to finish this out with this group of people and, you know, so badly. I know I'm sticking around next year, but, you know, the senior class is my group of closest friends. So to be able to do this together with my class was just amazing. And just watching, I can't even explain the emotions going through, like, just all of it. I honestly can't even put it into words entirely. You know, throwing my stick in the air, running to our goalie who had an amazing game, our defense, which had an amazing game. I just was, you know, props to every single person for doing their role on the field. It was unreal.
That's awesome. That's fantastic. Now let's look forward. What do you expect this weekend from Westfield State?
It's going to be a tough game. We've already started looking at some film, and we haven't played them before, but we have played some of their conference. So we're prepared to have a pretty gritty, tough game. You know, every single team that has entered the tournament has earned their spot there. So, you know, we need to be ready for anything, whether that be a strong, you know, we need to come in strong defensively, offensively, winning draws, and that all comes with prep. So we're already getting our heads in it, moving forward. I mean, it was great to win that conference championship, but, you know, we're moving on. It's time to win a first-round game. So ready for anything.
Outstanding. I look forward to seeing how far you guys are able to make a run in the NCAA tournament. Devin Sarazin, thank you so much. My next guest is Jen Fox Sargent, the head coach of the Roger Williams women's lacrosse team. And Jen, what does it mean to you to make the NCAA tournament this season?
Thanks, Bryce. It means the world, I think, especially this year, having gone through such a roller coaster of a year with COVID, and especially not having a season last year, and, you know, just being able to win that conference championship and move on to the tournament, it just means the world. And I'm just so happy that we can give our seniors and everyone, you know, at least one more game, hopefully more. But I know our girls deserve it. I think they've put in a lot of hard work all season and the off season. And so I just think their hard work has really paid off. And so I think, you know, for us, this means the world. So we're just so excited.
And you talk about that season, how it's been such a long and grueling type of season with everything else going on. Does it mean a little bit something extra? How does it feel to have this journey of and wild journey of a season culminate in success by first winning the CCC championship and now making it into the NCAA tournament?
Yeah, I think, you know, it shows a lot. You know, I think it proves that our team has been able to overcome adversity. And I just think our team has been so resilient. We've had highs, we've had lows. You know, I joke if there was a spring team who didn't get hit with some type of COVID issue, like you should go play the lottery, because I just think every single spring team, no matter what the division was this year, had to deal with these obstacles. And so, you know, we're talking, you know, we might be playing a game without some of our starters. How are people rising up to the occasion? You know, we have a game plan going in, but guess what? Someone can't come because I got a TMP on a test. So it's been a lot mentally, I think, on our girls, especially with the whole testing situation. And so it's almost like we're playing a game within the game. It's almost like I joked a couple games back that we're playing, like I almost want to get jerseys that say COVID on them and say like we're playing this team called COVID on top of our season as well. So it's been new. It's been different for our coaching staff to prep them mentally for this too. But I do think, you know, even in the fall, we tried to prep them as best we can to, you know, try to see what could have happened if someone tests positive, if, you know, the domino effect of being in quarantine, like how could that affect and how do we have to support our teammates? And so I think the preparation with our leadership ahead of time on the what ifs, I think really came through, because everything I feel like we kind of predicted and kind of, I guess, thought of any situation that could have happened kind of did. And so I think our girls were really, you know, prepped for as best we could, you know, how to deal with it and how to still support one another through it. And I think that prep is really kind of what helped us overcome some of the adversity that we hit with the COVID layer on top of this season. But yeah, no, the girls have really, I think, overcome adversity. And I think just despite not being able to bond as much, because we're a big team on, you know, team bonding and doing a lot of things off the field, we haven't been able to do as much. And so I think we've had to really get creative with how we make these connections off the field. And so I think that too has really been able to kind of take us to that next level, because we have found ways to still get, you know, super tight and super connected. And I think that obviously transfers onto the field. So I give a lot of props to our leadership too. They've helped big time with that.
And now, what was going through your mind as those final seconds ticked off the clock and you realized, wow, I'm going to be a CCC champion here at Roger Williams?
I think, you know, just having been in the championship with, you know, this team two times before, this time it felt a little different. This, I think for me, especially with the disappointment of last year's season being canceled, I knew what we had. And so I think for me as a coach, it's been frustrating not being able to show the talent that we have. And so when those final seconds, you know, were ticking in my mind, I was like, it's about time, you know. And I in the past, I might not have felt that as strongly. This time I'm like, yes, it's about time. We finally were able to get to this point, and I wanted to show everyone what we actually have, because I truly believe we're a very talented group. We obviously didn't get to really see that through last year because of the whole COVID situation. And so for me, it was just like, yes, it's about time. This is the team that I knew was going to win the conference championship. And so I couldn't be more proud of them.
Absolutely. And now looking forward, what do you expect this weekend from Westfield State?
Yeah, Westfield State's a very strong team. They just won their conference versus Framingham State on Saturday as well. Really tight battle. They're a very physical team. They have a couple of big studs on their team. And so we're starting to prep for that, watching a lot of film. I expect this to be a battle, and, you know, it's not going to be easy whatsoever. And so we really have to make sure, you know, we start to, you know, in our eyes, we're always looking at Endicott. And so we look at that all year. And so now we get a team we've never played before. And so it's like, how do we get them fired up in a week to try to play this team that they've never seen? And so I think a lot of our competitive athletes on the team, I think, are really starting to bring it at practice to try to still have that fire in their belly. But it's tough. None of our girls have ever been to a tournament before, and so it's a lot of like, what is this? Where are we going? And so it's kind of hard to gauge and try to envision what they're actually doing, but they're just so jacked up and excited. But at the end of the day too, we have to, you know, remind them this is a business trip. We got a business trip. We just got to get that first W and kind of go on from there. So it's going to be a tough battle. I expect you know, it's going to be very physical. But I'm excited, and hopefully the girls are ready to go.
Jen Fox Sargent, thank you so much, and good luck this weekend. Our next guest is Charlotte Perry of the Roger Williams women's lacrosse team. And Charlotte, what does it mean to you to have made the NCAA tournament?
It was so exciting. I've never been, so I'm like beyond thrilled to be able to do this with our team my senior year, kind of like cap it all off. Just really, it was just beyond exciting. I'm so happy that this team has been able to make it. We've been working so hard all year, so this is really like icing on the cake at this point.
Yeah, I can't imagine how exciting it is to finally be able to make the NCAA tournament, especially after being so close a couple of times. Now, what is it like to have such a crazy season of 2020 and this journey with COVID and everything kind of culminate in success by winning the CCC championship and now making the tournament?
I think it really speaks to the team's like hard work and dedication throughout the entire season from fall ball. Like, our fall ball was insane. We had practices way more than we usually do, to then going into season, having games canceled, and just everyone being able to bounce back and lean on each other for that support and make sure that when we did have games, we were winning those games.
Absolutely. And what was going through your mind in those final seconds and as they ticked off the clock in the CCC championship when you realized, wow, I'm about to be a Commonwealth Coast Conference champion?
I think it was just like a moment of complete, not shock, but just absolute like happiness. Like, I have been dreaming of this. Our team has been dreaming of this. We've been working so hard for it, like since my freshman year, and even the teams before that, we've been just... To actually be able to see the scoreboard and being like, oh my God, we just won, was just the best feeling, especially like being surrounded by my friends and partially part of some of my family. It was an amazing opportunity, and it was definitely something that I will look back on when I'm older and being like, that was so cool. That was just so cool to be able to do that.
Absolutely. And looking forward, what do you expect this weekend out of Westfield State?
I expect a battle. They're a really good team. They've been to the NCAAs the past couple of years, so they kind of have a little more experience on that end. But our team just coming off this like huge high, I think we're going to bring a lot of energy and a lot of excitement. And I think like not having that experience is going to might help us too. So I think we're just going to be out there like going to be a super gritty game, and we just got to keep our heads in it, and I think we'll do great.
Fantastic, and good luck this weekend, Charlotte Perry. Thanks so much. Our next guest is Barry Gorman, the head coach for the Roger Williams men's and women's tennis squads. And Barry, what does it mean to you and to your team to have made the CCC tournament?
Thanks, Bryce. Yeah, we're excited to be in the tournament. You know, we had a great regular season, and we're really looking forward to this tournament. You know, it's going to be a challenging one, and we're excited for Nichols tomorrow.
Absolutely, and like you said, you guys face off against Nichols, both the men's and women's squad, hosting after such a fantastic regular season. What do you expect from the Bison tomorrow?
We expect a tough match. It's always a tough match with Nichols, so we got to come out strong in the doubles and be ready. You know, they're going to be coming at us and ready to go, so we just got to come out ready to go in the doubles there with intensity, and you know, we're excited to play him again.
Outstanding, thanks so much, and good luck. And my next guest is Dan Taco of the Roger Williams men's tennis team. And Dan, what does it mean to you to make the CCC tournament?
I think it means a lot to us, especially as a team, and we've put a lot of hard work and effort in over the course of this season, and it's been a different season, to say the least, and I think our hard work has paid off.
You call this season different. I prefer the word crazy and kind of an extra journey. And to have that journey kind of culminate in some success, making the CCC tournament, what has that been like? Does it kind of make it more fulfilling?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, with the season getting canceled last year, we only had the opportunity to play in the playoffs my freshman year, and that was cut short. But I think making the tournament this year just shows what we're capable of as a team and what we can do for the future of this program.
Absolutely. And do you guys get a tough test here in the first round as you face off against the Nichols College Bison? What do you expect from them?
I expect a tough, grueling match. And Nichols being our competitor, I expect there to be a lot of fight from both sides. And I think it'll also be a very exciting and interesting match to watch. And it'll be really exciting too.
Absolutely, Dan Taco. Thank you so much. And my final guest is Heidi Martin of the Roger Williams women's tennis squad. And Heidi, What does it mean to you and to your team to have made the CCC tournament?
Myself and all the girls were super excited to be in the tournament. We've been working all year for it. We didn't have any matches in the fall, so we've really been competing hard all spring to get here, and we're just really looking forward to it.
Absolutely, and it's been a really crazy season, really a journey for you and your team. What does it mean to you to have kind of culminate in success in making the CCC tournament?
I think it really just goes to show like all of our hard work is paying off and that we just have to keep working hard and to advance past Nichols. That's the goal, and that's our main focus. So just all of our hard work and effort, we just have to put that into play and hope for the best.
Absolutely, and you mentioned Nichols. You get a tough task against Nichols. You really were in a battle with them the first time you played them this year. What do you expect out of the Bison here tomorrow?
I think it's going to be a really intense match, lots of energy from both sides. I think both of us are going to really fight until the very end, and it's just going to be back and forth just like it was in our first match. But I know myself and the girls, we're ready to go, and we're going to give it everything we have.
Fantastic, Heidi Martin. Thank you so much, and good luck tomorrow. That's all we got for today. Thank you so much for tuning into Hawk Talk. For Devin Sarazen, Jen Fox Sargent, Charlotte Perry, Barry Gorman, Dan Taco, and Heidi Martin, I am your host, Bryce Johnson, signing off for Hawk Talk.